Alright guys, here I am, video update. Surprise, surprise, my black marble and pearl scale are back at it again. The black marble being the male, and the pearl scale is the female. She's laying the eggs, he's following up behind her, fertilizing the eggs. This is the second spawn attempt. I tried to raise the first spawn in a 75 gallon tank, and I got the eggs all the way through wiggler stage to the free swimming stage. I put them in the marina breeding box and the fry didn't do too well. They died off. They didn't take to the brine shrimp. They weren't feeding and they weren't really active. I had them in there with the koi fry and they weren't responding to the feedings. They just were laying at the bottom, very lazy, lethargic, and not really feeding on the brine shrimp. My koi fry, however, did well, and I got a nice little number of koi fry in my marina breeding box overhead. And so what I did was I put these guys in their own little 20 gallon high tank. I got little sponge floats in the back from Angels Plus that you could see, little heater and thermometer. I have everything set at 82 degrees. I did a nice little water change, maybe 50%, threw a little bit cooler water in there, and here we are. I got lucky. They started spawning. They're putting out a nice little generous amount of eggs. They just got started maybe five minutes ago. And I'm really happy about this batch. Curious because the female's a pearl scale and the male's black. So I'm hoping that I get black pearl scale from this pair. And keeping my fingers crossed. And I hope that's what comes out of this pair, because I've never seen black pearl scale angelfish before. So I'm going to keep you guys updated as to what's going on with this set of fry and how they progress in the stages that they go through. So, you know, as always guys, post your comments, subscribe. I'm going to keep the updates coming on both my tanks and my fry and, you know, my whole setup. And I hope you guys like what you see, and I'm getting a lot of fish. So hopefully I can get rid of these things, maybe sell them off, or, you know, local pet shops, get store credit, or, you know, some type of funds to help me keep doing what I like to do. So I hope you guys are enjoying these videos. I'm going to keep you guys posted regularly as always. You know, give me some positive feedback. I'm really trying. I'm relatively new to this. I've only been having my spawning pair spawn for maybe a week now. And this is the third spawn. I had two spawns from this pair and one spawn from my koi pair. And the koi have been successful. I've gotten the koi all the way through. They're feeding vigorously. They eat really well. And I just got to get these guys through. And I'm really curious as to how the fry are going to look when they develop. So I'm going to parent raise this batch. I hope I got a good set of parents on my hands. They take good care of their babies and they protect the fry, and the fry feed well, and hopefully the fry are a little bit more active when they're with the parents. So I'm going to parent raise these fish, and I'm hoping that a majority of them get through and I can see what they look like when they get a little bit older, and maybe I could keep some of them for my next batch of breeders, and you know, I could continue trying to make new strains of angelfish, or, you know, try to do something a little bit different from what everybody else is doing out there. So hopefully everything goes well. Keeping my fingers crossed, and only time is going to tell what happens with this batch. So I'm going to keep you guys posted. Wish me luck. Any advice, always welcome, please. Anybody knows anything about these fish, I'm welcome to all ideas. And I will try anything that will work and help these fish along their way. So I'm going to give you guys a little bit more video. And they seem to be putting out a nice batch of eggs. So that male's watching me. He's not so crazy about me being next to the tank. She's starting to fan them a little bit. And this is a really beautiful pair of angelfish. I think this is my nicest pair that I have so far. I love my koi pair, and they're great. I've had those fish since they were dime size, and I practically raised them. These guys, I got my pearl scale female from Angels Plus, and I got this black male veil from a local pet store a friend of mine owns, and I couldn't pass him up. He's just gorgeous. He's gigantic. He's a very big angel fish. Biggest one I've ever seen in person. I've seen some big ones on YouTube, but this guy is really big in person. He has nice fins. I don't know how old he is. I would say he's probably 2 years old. He definitely got to be over the 1 year mark, because he's at breeding age, and he's a pretty big angel fish. I think he's been growing for a little while now. So I'm going to keep them around. Hopefully I can get a few batches out of these guys and be successful with a spawn. So as always, guys, post your comments, subscribe, thumbs up this video if you like it, and check my videos, support my videos. I'm going to keep them coming. As soon as I get the chance, I'm going to post up more updates and keep you guys posted as to what's going on with the angelfish situation. And I'm going to do a quick little overview in one of my next videos on the angelfish breeding setup. I have a nice little 75-gallon tank where I keep the main fish at. And I just got this 20 high for my breeding pair over here. And I got a small little 5-gallon for a brine shrimp hatchery to feed to my fry. And I'm hopefully going to get another 20-gallon high and separate the other pair from the 75, put them in their own 20, or maybe get a... I'm thinking about getting into a few Philippine blues and maybe pairing off some Philippine blues so that way I could get some fry from them. And kicking around a few ideas, maybe some red koi. I'm really interested in those red koi from Angels Plus. They're really very, very red. I like the colors on them, and I think they'll attract a lot of attention if I hopefully turn around and sell them. So, you know, just kicking around a few ideas. If you guys got any ideas, send your ideas my way. I'm willing to try anything that sounds good. So, you know. All right. I'm going to let these guys be. Leave them alone. They're probably a little nervous because I'm close by their tank, and I want them to put out a good spawn for me. And I'm going to let them go about their business, leave them alone, and hopefully tomorrow I'll give you a nice little update video. You'll see the eggs and see how many they put out, and I'll do a quick little update for them. Alright? Wish me luck, and hopefully I get a lot of eggs out of these two. Alright, so I'm going to say bye. You guys have a good one. Happy fish keeping. Thank you. Bye.